in come three boys who had obviously been partying, one of whom seems to have a large object attached to his body.
Hutch, stop moving. You're just too holding still.
How are we supposed to hold still when we're walking?
That large object is what we call an alligator snapping turtle. A snapping turtle can snap your finger clean off. It can bite through a broomstick. This is a serious bite.
How did all this happen?
Well, we were out noodling for catfish and we found a hole with a turtle in it.
When it turned to try to dig in, Bo pulled it out by its tail.
This particular bite is in the area of the carotid artery and the internal jugular vein. So if we got it upset and it started clamping and biting harder, it could injure the carotid. And if it punctured the carotid, Bo could bleed out in about 4 minutes and die.
A game warden has warned Dr. Slay that if he kills the snapping turtle on his patient's neck, these catfish noodlers are going to jail.
Why should I have to go to prison on account of his stupidity?
While Bo's buddies are debating the finer points of justice and the law, Warden, we have no intention of killing that turtle or letting it die. Their replacements show up. Why don't you two boys go take a break in the waiting room? I'd managed to get the two good old boys out of there, but we still have the turtle firmly attached to my patient's neck. Anybody have any other ideas?
How about if we block its nostrils? I mean, it needs to open its mouth to breathe, right?
I have seen a snapping turtle hold its breath for more than half an hour.
Half an hour? I'm in pain here.
So now what?
Doc, those meds you gave me, they ain't doing a thing. This still hurts like the devil.
It finally occurs to me, what if we paralyze it?
You can't paralyze that turtle.
It would just be temporary paralysis.
Hell yeah, let's paralyze it.
And I'm thinking, well, gee, I could give a shot of succinylcholine for Susie, and she'll let go.
Excuse me, doctor, but if you give her succinylcholine, you'll need to intubate to keep her alive. Have you ever intubated a turtle before?
And the answer to that question is no.
Oh, what the hell are you doing?
She's peeing on me.
If you ask me, that was Susie's way of telling me what she thought of my idea. When I woke up that morning, I sure didn't think I'd be intubating a snapping turtle.
All right, what dosage of sex?
I calculate the dose for about a 30-pound child.
100 milligrams.
I'm kind of shaking. I'm nervous about this whole thing.
Here we go.
Stick it in, draw back. I get blood. I'm in a vein. I squirt the succinylcholine. It works pretty fast, usually in about a minute or two. And lo and behold, her mouth drops open.
Oh, wow.
We look where the bite is.
How bad is it?
It's not bad. He has a little bit of a superficial laceration and some swelling, but there's no active bleeding, thank God.
You're gonna be fine. We're gonna clean it up and give you a tetanus shot.
But now, Susie has stopped breathing. I use a pair of forceps to force her mouth open.
Okay, Susie, here we go.
I go down the base of the tongue and there's a little epiglottis up and down. Slide the tube in. We hook it up to a little pediatric bag and oxygen and we start ventilating.
Come on, girl.
She's moving.
Okay.
And lo and behold, Susie starts digging, opening her eyes, and breathing on her own.
She's moving. Okay.
Yes!
All right, listen, I'm gonna pull.
And we decide it's time to take her back to the swamp where she belongs.
We're leaving those turtles alone from now on, right?
Yes, sir.
Doc?
Later, Susie.
The best looking hickey you ever got.